Hello everyone, I'm Assistant Professor Ms. Bashik, associated with LG Integrated MBA. Today we are going to discuss part 2 of our module 2 from the subject mergers and acquisition. Now let us discuss the topic taxation for mergers and acquisition. Under the taxation laws, according to the section 2.1b, amalgamation in relation to the company means the merger of one or more companies with another. The merger of two or more companies to form a new company in such a manner that all the properties and liability of amalgamating company becomes a property or liability of amalgamated company. Shareholders having 75% or more value of shares become the shareholders of the amalgamated company. The loss of amalgamating company should be set off and carried forward by the amalgamated company by the virtue of section 72A. The income of the amalgamating company from the effective date of the transfer shall be assessed as the income of the amalgamated company and shall be assessed accordingly. Now let us see the capital gain tax exceptions for mergers and acquisition. As per section 47, exceptions to the following transactions in given from the charging section, that is section 45, transfer of the capital assets by holding company to its subsidiary company or vice versa, transfer of a capital asset in a scheme of amalgamation, transfer of shares held in Indian company in a scheme of amalgamation between two foreign companies by the amalgamating foreign company. Now let us discuss the Competition Act 2002 and its regulations for mergers and acquisition. The Competition Bill 2001 was introduced in Lok Sabha by former Finance Minister Mr. Arun Jaitley on 6th August 2001. It replaced the MRTP Act 1969, that is Monopolies and Restricted Trade Practices Act. The Competition Act emerged as an improvement over MRTP Act to shift the focus from controlling monopoly to initiating competition in the economy. This act has formed a Competition Commission of India, which has a number of power to promote, issue and levy permissions and punishments to the firms which affects the market in a negative way. Objectives of this act are to eliminate the practices having adverse effect on competition, to promote and sustain competition in the market, to protect consumers' interest, and to ensure freedom of the trade carried on by other participants in the market of Indian economy. Section 5 and 6 of Competition Act lays set of regulations for mergers and acquisition, or we can say it as combination. Broadly, combination under the Competition Act means acquisition of control, shares, voting rights or assets, acquisition of control by a person over an enterprise where such a person has direct or indirect control over another enterprise engaged in competing business, and merger and amalgamation between or among the enterprises when the combining parties exceed the threshold set in the Act. The thresholds are specified in the Act in terms of assets or turnover in India and outside India. Regulation of combination regulations are as follows. No person or enterprise shall enter into a combination which causes or is likely to cause an appreciable adverse effect on the competition within the relevant market in India, subject to the provision contained in subject section 1. Any person or enterprise who or which proposes to enter into the combination may at his or its opinion give notice to the commission. First is that approval of the proposal relating to the merger or amalgamation, and second is execution of any agreement or other document or acquisition referred to in a clause A of the section 5, or the acquiring of control referred in the clause B of the section 5. Third point is that the commission shall, after receipt of the notice under subsection 2, deal with such notice in accordance with the provision contained in section 29, 30 and 31. Fourth regulation is that the provision of this section shall not apply to share, subscription or financial facilities or any acquisition by the public financial institutions. Fifth point under this head is that the public financial institution, foreign institutional investors, banks or venture capital funds referred to in subsection 4 shall within 7 days from the date of acquisition file in the form of, as it may be specified by the regulation, with the commission to detailed of the acquisition, including the details of the control and circumstances of the amalgamation. In our next session, we are going to study SEBI's rules and regulations and other topics related to the module 2 of your subject. Thank you.